It's kind of inspiring.
You might think everybody was a shrinking violet, but this was not the case. Not the case at all.
And I just really liked some of those crazy women who just really went and took things by the reins, and Monterey County is a better place for it. So
you see people who were going against the norms of the day.
Basically, like you did, changing the camera a little bit, we can find what has always been there. We just never recognized it.
It's good to look back and see that there have been perhaps not as many opportunities as we have today, but women, if they had the opportunity, they would grasp it and go with it, despite the odds.
In the county, the Equal Opportunities Office mission is to provide equal opportunity to all. I'll confess, I also have an ulterior motive. I love history, and anytime I can trick people into going to a history lecture, I'll do it.
Women who traveled here very early, when Monterey was a backwater, and came with their husbands died, but they were left with 12 children and they had to support them. And so what do you do under those circumstances? I think women in all generations will rise to the occasion.
California is one of those unique places where it is the Wild West still, and it was totally the Wild West then, and you had a little bit more freedom than the staunch, you know, tradition of cities back east or in Europe.
Well, I think people are always surprised at the scope of what women did in the past. Many people might think that perhaps they were homemakers, raising children, but they also had a lot of other things that they were working at too. People in all walks of life, so education, medicine, agriculture. Women have worked as business people, entrepreneurs.
They shape it because they were the pioneers, truly, literally, figuratively, however you want to put it. It's just really rare to see a woman in a beautiful dress also running a restaurant and a boarding house and given the autonomy to do that.
The other part of it is we benefit from diversity. Now, diversity is, it's bringing together different experiences, different lives, to tackle our shared problems from different viewpoints. I'm very thankful to work for an employer, the County of Monterey, that actually values this diversity through all the policies, all the trainings that we do. You know, they not just say it, but they do it.
The Board of Supervisors, just from the perspective of honoring diversity and wanting to make sure that our workplace is reflective of the community and really respects and honors all people, and the recognition that when you have a diverse workforce, you're bringing different perspectives to the table, and all of those viewpoints are important to really be able to create policy and programs and deliver services out to a very diverse community.
The most visible aspects of the Equal Opportunity Office are investigations and trainings. We have the Equal Opportunity, Non-Discrimination, and Diversity Training. Again, this is above and beyond what is legally required and board mandated, because they want to create a better working environment for county employees.
Just in general, you see that women doing the same work as men are paid less. And we look now, our Equal Opportunity Office in the last few years has done a great job of finding ways to monitor our progress in terms of, well, recruitment, hiring, and promotion of minorities and women. I think in the mid-70s, there were, of the 20 job classes, let's say, there were 10 or 12 where minorities were underrepresented. You look now and it's two or three. You look at in the same time period, in the mid to late 70s, 20 of the 20 job classes, half were underemploying women. It's the same number today.
You know, the pay gap is something that still needs addressing, but that comes when you get involved, and that comes when you try and make a strategic plan to put female voices at the table, and that's what we do, you know, and that's what we're all about.
So it's almost an invisible issue because we see women around, but if you really look at where women are in the organization and how equitable the hiring and promotion opportunities are, you start to see the discrepancies. And so having something like a Women's History Month, having a commission on the status of women, and having people be able to bring attention to these issues is important, because otherwise it is a little bit invisible, and so we might not pay as much attention to it as we should be paying.
And so what I recommend for people my age and anyone who wants to get their voice heard, especially people in minority demographics, you know, if you're a professional and you have the drive to do it, you just have to make a plan on how to slowly but surely make your way into positions where your voice gets heard.
But women in the leadership and decision-making positions, you just need 30% as a minimum to start making decisions that are better for the organization. When there are women, there's more listening that happens, more collaboration for problem solving, a little bit more emphasis on where we want to go for the future, and then working our way back to, so then what does that mean that we do today? We're nowhere close to 30%, and of course we make up half the population, so I really encourage women to look for the opportunities within their workplaces, within their communities, to get involved, because we need more women in those leadership positions, on boards, in top management, and then we're going to be getting the kind of decision making that benefits the whole community. Thank you.